Hello everyone, welcome to Biologics once again. How are you guys? So today we are going to discuss about the nucleotide and nucleoside. Okay, so before starting this video, if you have not gone through my previous video in which I have discussed about the ingredients of nucleic acid, okay, what are the things through which nucleic acids are made up of. So to watch that video, you can go in the description box where I have provided the link of that video. Okay, so let's discuss. This is the extension of that video. Okay, so let's start this video with the nucleoside. So here we'll be discuss about the difference between the nucleoside and nucleotide, right? So what is nucleoside? The nucleoside is made up of two things. One is base and second one is sugar. Okay, so here you can see that this is the structure of sugar, okay, and this is the structure of nitrogenous base. Okay, so let's start with this structure. So sugar may be either deoxyribose or ribose. Okay, as I told you in previous video that if there is H present on the carbon number second of sugar, okay, then it will be deoxyribose because it lacks oxygen at carbon number second. Okay, and if at carbon number second there is OH group present, okay, then it will be ribose sugar. So the sugar may be either ribose or deoxyribose. Okay, now second thing is there is one nitrogenous base. Okay, so this nitrogenous base either may be either purine or pyrimidine. Okay, so if purine is present, then either there will be A or G, adenine or guanine. So one of them may be present. Okay, so now third thing is, what are the carbon atoms through which the nitrogenous base and sugar is attached? Okay, so the carbon number 9 of nitrogenous base, okay, especially purine, we are talking right now about purine. If purine is present as nitrogenous base, then the carbon number 9 of the purine will be linked to the carbon number 1 of the sugar, right? And they will form the bond that is known as glycosidic bond. Okay, so in nucleoside, if purine is present, okay, then the carbon number 9 of nitrogenous base and carbon number 1 of sugar will be involved in the formation of glycosidic bond. Okay, now we will move towards the second structure, that is if the nitrogenous base is pyrimidine. Okay, so you know that what are the bases that comes under the pyrimidine? Cytosine, uracil or thymine, right? Now if pyrimidine is present in the structure of nucleoside, then what are the carbon atoms that are involved in the formation of glycosidic bond, right? So the carbon number 1 of pyrimidine nitrogenous base, that can be either cytosine, uracil or thymine. So the carbon number 1 of pyrimidine base and carbon number 1 of the sugar are involved in the formation of glycosidic bond. Okay, so this was the structure of nucleoside where two things are present, base and sugar. Okay, now before going to the structure of nucleotide, which is made up of base, sugar and phosphate, here phosphate is not present. So this is the basic difference between the nucleoside and nucleotide. Here only base and sugar is present in the nucleoside, but in nucleotide there is phosphate group also present. Okay, now the last thing about the nucleoside is, if the nucleoside we are talking about in RNA, what are the terms given to the respective nucleosides? So if adenine is present as a nitrogenous base, then it will be called as adenosine. The complete structure will be called as adenosine. If guanine is present as nitrogenous base, then the complete structure will be known as guanosine. And if cytosine is present, then it will be known as cytidine. And if the uracil is present, okay, at a nitrogenous base, then it will be called as uridine, right? Now if we will talk about the nucleoside of DNA, okay, so what are the terms we have given? So if the adenine is present in the nucleoside of DNA, then it will be known as deoxyadenosine, right? So deoxy will be added, right? If guanine is present as a nitrogenous base, then it will be known as deoxyguanosine, deoxycytidine, deoxythymidine, right? So I hope you understood this, right? Now we will move towards the nucleotide which is made up of base, sugar and phosphate. Okay, now you can see here that this is the structure of sugar again. Okay, that may be either ribose or deoxyribose. Okay, depending upon the atom which is present at the carbon number second. Okay, now we are talking about nucleotide where there is one phosphate group is also present. The rest of the structure is same as I told you in the nucleoside. Okay, so I am not explaining that again. You can rewind the video and watch it. Now, important thing is if we talk about the nucleotide in DRNA, what we will call them? Okay, so if adenine is present in the structure of nucleotide as a nitrogenous base, then it will be called as adenylate. If guanosine is present as a nitrogenous base, it will be called as guanylate. Okay, if cytosine is present, it will be called as cytidylate. If uracil is present, then it will be called as uridylate. Okay, so this we were talking about the RNA. If nucleotide is present in the RNA, if we talk about the nucleotide in DNA, what we call them? If adenine is present as a nitrogenous base, we call it deoxyadenylate. Okay, if guanosine is guanine is present, then we will call as deoxyguanylate, deoxycytidylate, deoxythymidylate. So deoxy will be added. Okay, so this thing and this thing. Okay, thus terminology of nucleoside and nucleotide you need to understand. Okay, this is important in context of the exam. Okay, so this is all about the nucleoside and nucleotide. I hope you understood this tutorial, and if you like this video, please subscribe our channel and share with your friends. Thank you so much.